Do you need maths for data science? Yep, you definitely need it. Now that we have that out of the way, the real question is, how much maths do you really need? Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Leon. So maths is always the big elephant in the room. Nobody wants to talk about it, but eventually everyone has to address it. I can say from my experience that it's not really a question of do you need to learn maths with data science, but a question of how much and what type of maths do you actually need to learn. Now, I've got a bachelor's degree in maths, so I've done a fair amount of maths in my life. And to be honest, most of the stuff that I've learned in my degree, I've never actually had to use in real life. I've never thought, hey, you know what? Let's prove Pythagoras' theorem. Yeah, no, that's never happened. So does that mean you only need the absolute basics of stats and algebra to get by? Well, not exactly. You see, this is where it gets kind of difficult to judge how much and what type of maths do you need to learn. It really depends on the type of data science role that you're after. However, I do think there's a minimum required amount of maths that you need to know in order to get into entry-level data science roles. I'll put the timestamps up here somewhere in case you want to skip ahead, but what I'm going to do in this video is go over the type of maths and how much of it do you need to learn in order to have a good solid foundation for data science. Let's get right into it. First, I think before we even get into the more specialized topics, I think it's important to know the absolute basics of maths. You need to understand how functions work, since you might be dealing with loss functions in machine learning, or polynomial functions in linear regression, or even logarithmic and exponential functions. You need to be comfortable with variables, since you'll be dealing with them a lot in statistics. You need to understand how equations work, since you might be trying to convert some of them into your own code. And of course, you need to be able to read and plot different types of graphs, since for data visualization, that's what you're going to be doing most of the time. Basic statistical understanding is probably the most important skill to have for data science. Statistics is about quantifying uncertainty. Without understanding this, you're not going to be able to interpret your own results, and as such, you won't be able to make informed decisions. A foundational topic in statistics is probability theory. This is all about quantifying uncertainty and understanding randomness. There's a reason why pretty much every beginner course starts with this topic, and that's because this forms the foundation for all of the advanced statistical theories that you'll learn later. You need to understand probabilities for things like distributions, hypothesis testing, and so on. So if you don't have a foundation already in statistics, this is the topic I would start with. The next topic that you definitely need to get to grips with is descriptive statistics. This is where you start analyzing and understanding the basic features of your data. Descriptive statistics is used to understand things like the distribution of your data, also the central tendency of your data, so things like the mean, median, and mode, and also the spread of your data, so standard deviation and variance. The point is, if you don't understand even the basic makeup of your data, then you're not going to be able to know which statistical methods to apply. Another important topic is hypothesis testing, and some people call this A/B testing, but essentially it's just to test the plausibility of your hypothesis. This is used a lot in scientific research, for example in drug testing, to see whether a drug has any efficacy. Some companies use this to test whether a new feature is worth implementing. Basically, hypothesis testing evaluates the significance of your results, and it helps you in asking questions scientifically based on data. And then there's regression, which is often used for making predictions and forecasting. The most simple and well-known form of regression is linear regression, which is just drawing a line of best fit through a bunch of data points. And understanding regression will help a lot in topics like machine learning, since there's a big overlap. And then just very quickly, some understanding of model evaluation will be extremely useful to you at some point in your data science career. This is especially true if you're building stats or machine learning models, because you want to be able to know which model is the best one to use. The next type of maths that you need to know is linear algebra. So the entire foundation of certain machine learning algorithms like deep learning are based entirely on linear algebra. So it's important to know if you want to take machine learning seriously. First, a good understanding of matrices and vectors will be beneficial for you in machine learning in general. And some Python libraries like NumPy are designed to handle matrices and vectors. So some understanding of how they work is going to help. And then there's eigenvalues and eigenvectors, which are needed to understand techniques like principal component analysis, which reduce the dimensionality of data whilst minimizing information loss. In my opinion, it makes the most sense to move on to eigenvalues and eigenvectors once you've got a good foundation in matrices and vectors. So calculus isn't really something that you use most of the time, but it is something that's needed to understand optimization problems. You'll need to understand how derivatives and integrals work, since they're used in gradient descent in loss functions, and also integrals are used in things like backpropagation in neural networks. Loss functions are always talked about in machine learning, and there are many different types of loss functions, so knowing how derivatives and integrals work will help you when you start training your own machine learning models. Modern computer science is built almost entirely on discrete maths, so having some understanding of this is going to help. In discrete maths, you should learn about algorithm complexity, so you'll know how long your algorithms will take to run and also how difficult it is to use them to solve your problem. Since I don't have a computer science background, this was something that I picked up on later on, but I actually found it very useful every time I wanted to learn more about an algorithm. And then there's set theory, which is something that I thought was completely useless until I actually started working with databases. Now, you don't need set theory to actually start working with databases, but since relational databases are built almost entirely on the logic of set theory, having some knowledge of it is going to help you understand the processes that happen in the background. And by extension, you'll be able to build and optimize better database models. And then lastly, there's graph theory, which helps with understanding how graph databases work. Most social network data is held in graph databases, so if you're doing any social network analysis, you'll know which algorithms to apply and also how to optimize them. Hopefully, I've given you some ideas on where to start and how much you actually need to know. This all obviously depends on what kind of data scientist you want to be, but I'd say this is a pretty standard overview of what's required. If you're interested, I've got some more data science videos that you can check out up here somewhere. And if you want to stay updated, please like and subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one.